for that live down cap. Chris Renge Foxes.
All right, thank you so much, Chris. Well, World War II was the largest and deadliest war of its kind. It was fought by land, sea, and air. Now, a group of pilots are fighting to make sure what happened isn't only recorded, but also preserved.
A piece of that mission still existing in St. Charles County. Fox 2's Calista Matrician joins us with the story.
It's tucked behind acres of cornfields in Portage du Sault, and it's a piece of history, first used as an auxiliary training base for the Naval Air Station. Now you'll find the centuries-old hangar that's pushing the past into the present.
RS Regiment, four-star checklist.
Superchargers.
Nolan Lab.
Prop levers.
RPM. You can touch and feel these airplanes. These airplanes, when you hear them running, you see them flying, when they're on the ground, to be able to go up and touch them.
Now imagine it's World War II, and you're in the nose of this bomber jet. At the time, the brand new North American B-25 Mitchell.
The B-25 that you'll see out here will turn 80 years old at the end of this year. As we get further and further away from that time, the memory starts to fade and the history is a little more difficult.
But the commemorative Air Force is keeping that time alive for the younger generations. And Wing Leader Rob Jenner says he's noticing a change in perception.
It's to reflect back on the mistakes we did in the past and make sure we don't do that again.
Lawrence Barron is only 14 years old, but he's taking particular interest in warcraft.
It's kind of fascinating that people would do that, like with bombs, or especially in that plane. It's a little cramped in there.
He trains with the Commemorative Air Force and even flies with the group. They do about 15 air shows per year.
It's been pretty fun. I got to do some hands-on stuff, cleaning the plane, doing maintenance on it. And we kind of found it in like Illinois, and we made it into that.
He says there's more to this operation than just the fun of flying.
So I can keep this thing alive for as long as possible, for generations and generations to see.
Have you flown up in one of the airplanes before?
Yeah.
18-year-old James Perkins is also part of CAF.
I want to learn about World War II airplanes.
Including this torpedo bomber, which is the same model that President George H.W. Bush was flying when he was shot down in the Pacific.
If you look around the museum, you'll see, for instance, there is a D-Day display. Now, over here on this side, you'll see what was going on at home, the home front. And that reflects a lot of St. Louis. And you'll see over there, for instance, the Cardinals in the World Series in 1944 during the war.
Honing in on the home front, Jenner explains the group's Missouri wing is focusing on an educational outreach program to further develop aeronautics into STEM.
And the Inspire part leans to the younger kids. So it is to inspire and educate these kids and hopefully promote and move them into the STEM, the sciences, aeronautics, aviation. So it is a nationwide effort geared toward those.
The Commemorative Air Force plans to show more classrooms, some call signs, and Lawrence tells me this school year he plans to start his own warcraft club. If you'd like to come check out these giant aircraft and learn more on their stories, head to our website for those details at fox2now.com. All right, wonderful.